Greetings. I recently heard some information that makes me think I've been wrong. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video so that you may gain understanding. I'm not talking about the core fundamentals of the truth, but I've been fairly straightforward declaring Islam is the religion of the Antichrist. I think that may have been off, incorrect by a few degrees. I recently heard about an effort in Germany, the HouseOfOne. It is an interesting effort for Muslims, Christians, and Jews to share a single place of worship. The website for this effort is houseofone.org. The documentation is in German, which I do not speak or read. But with Google Translate change word from Deutsch to English using, some details charter written in and images make clarification schemen. If you speak and read German, please laugh at my poor Anglo public education. And perhaps you can read the site materials for to confirm or correct this. From what I can gather, the building will basically resemble the following. The Friday people will have a wing. The Saturday people will have a wing. And the Sunday people will have a wing. Connected by a common area where folks can all meet on neutral ground. The video where I first heard this mentioned included a few doctrinal details, but so far I have not been able to confirm or refute said details. The website for this effort is houseofone.org. They have videos and architectural images and jobs. Vacancy, marketing, public relations. The HouseOfOne Berlin is looking for a director, marketing, public relations. This will be one of the biggest marketing snow jobs in human history. There are press releases. They focus on peace. After all, who could speak against the siren call of peace and safety? Peace and safety. Nothing to fear here. Now, this is where I would appreciate some help from German linguists and other Bereans. Read the marketing BS. Trigger on the meaningless and deceptive buzzwords. This whole blending must ultimately end with compromise and corruption of the gospel. For example, if there is any, and I mean any, need to accept the Quran as divinely inspired, this effort is damned. Or if to placate the Islamic contingent, Christians cannot say Jesus is God or Jesus is Lord, this effort is damned. Or if to placate the Islamic contingent, Christians cannot pray in Jesus' name, this effort is damned. Or if Christians must concede that Jesus is created or only just a prophet, this effort is damned. Can you begin to see the pattern, the common thread? This effort is damned. There is no compromise between good and evil. There is no compromise between God and Satan. Light has no fellowship with darkness. Christians and Jews do not worship the pagan Allah of ancient Arabia. But we do know of the entity. Isaiah 14:12, "How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? For you have said in your heart, I will ascend into heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. O Satan, you have desired to be Akbar. You command your minions to declare you are Akbar. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. But you will never be like Yahweh, the Most High God. There will never be any truth in shouts of Satan hu Akbar, not even if you call yourself Allah. Yet you shall be brought down to hell, to the sides of the pit. Satan loses in the end. It matters not if Satan has tricked billions of people to worship him as Allah. Except to the sincere, deceived souls who follow his scheme into eternity. Because Satan is the best deceiver, the all-mocker. John 8:44, he was a murderer from the beginning, refusing to uphold the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he lies, he speaks his native language, because he is a liar and the father of lies. I began this video saying, I think I've been wrong. I believe it may be wrong to insist that the religion of the Antichrist will be pure Islam. Clearly, Islam denies the Father and the Son. 1 John 2:22, who is the liar but he who denies that Jesus is the Christ? This is the Antichrist, he who denies the Father and the Son. Clearly, Islam denies the Son of God was crucified. Clearly, Islam denies the Son of God was raised from the dead. Romans 10:9, that if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Clearly, Islam denies God has come in the flesh. 1 John 4:2, by this you know the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses Jesus Christ having come in the flesh is of God. Even if you insist pure Islam is false, but can be reformed, you will perhaps be susceptible to meaningless, unscriptural tweaks and polishes. You may find yourself susceptible to the strong delusion, because you have not loved the truth. This bastard form of compromise just may be a significant facet of the one world religion. Do not, in these last days, let the words of Apostle Paul apply to you, brothers and sisters. Galatians 1:6, I am astonished how quickly you are deserting the one who called you by the grace of Christ and are turning to a different gospel. Which is not even a gospel. It's not even good news. Evidently, some people are troubling you and trying to distort the gospel of Christ. But even if we, or an angel from heaven, should preach a gospel contrary to the one we preached to you, let him be under a divine curse. Did you know that Muhammad claimed an angel gave him Islam? An angel preached a different message than the one the apostles preached. If we or an angel from heaven should preach a gospel contrary to the one we preached to you. Contrary means different or changed. Contrary to the one already preached, the one we preached to you. That pretty much damns the scheme and deception of abrogation. Getting back on track. Galatians 1:9. As we have said before, even now I say again. You know, people repeat things that are important. If anyone is preaching a gospel to you contrary to what you received, let him be accursed. Do not let rationales of peace and safety deceive you. 1 Thessalonians 5:3, for when they shall say peace and security, then suddenly destruction comes upon them, as the labor pains to her having in womb, and they shall not escape. Suddenly. Think mousetrap. It will be hard, my friend. All men want peace and safety, but do not foolishly give up the truth. For when they shall say peace and security, then suddenly destruction comes upon them, as the labor pains to her having a child in womb, and they shall not escape. A pregnant woman knows she is getting ready to pop, but that first labor pain must always get met with What was that? And then it is too late. The labor process has begun. This past week, the verse that has constantly come to mind is this. John 21:17. Jesus asked a third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was deeply hurt that Jesus had asked him a third time, "Do you love me?" "Lord, you know all things," he replied. "You know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." And I have sought to understand the focus or change in focus this may or may not imply. I know not if this is God's mind or not. But even a purely secular, rational analysis would identify two aspects of the Christian walk. One, teach and make disciples of all men. Luke 24:46, "And he said to them, Thus it has been written, the Christ was to suffer and to rise out from the dead on the third day. And in his name repentance and forgiveness of sins will be proclaimed to all nations, beginning in Jerusalem." Matthew 28:18. "And having come to them, Jesus spoke to them, saying, All authority in heaven and on the earth has been given to me. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." And point two, having made disciples, disciple them, teach them, train them, strengthen them. Luke 22:31, "And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has desired to have you that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for you, Simon, that your faith will not fail. And when you have turned back, strengthen your brothers." Strengthen the brothers and sisters in Christ. Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep. If you love me, feed my sheep." Hold fast, meaning hang on to your faith. Hebrews 4:14. "Therefore, since we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession." Hebrews 10:23. "We should hold fast to the confession of our hope, unwavering, for the one having promised is faithful." Ephesians 6:13. "Therefore take up the whole armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you will be able to stand your ground, and having done everything, to stand." Hebrews 10:36. "For you have need of endurance, perseverance, patience, so that having done the will of God, you may receive the promise." If you are Muslim and your heart is troubled, I pray that you would honestly cry out to God. The God of the prophets does not desire that you perish. 1 Timothy 2:3, "This is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth." God has guided you here, brother, so that you may hear the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.